Lately, I've been spending more time alone, voluntary solitude, if you will, in an attempt to cultivate stillness. I spent most of June all alone without really talking to a soul, reading, riding my bike, listening to music, meditating, practicing film photography, guitar, and just being present in nature. I just hid away from the world in an attempt to make sense of things. A lot of sitting in silence, thinking about the life I was living, and sometimes not even thinking at all. It's been almost 3 months now since I started living out of my four-wheel drive, and to be honest, I've enjoyed every minute of it. The thrill of not knowing where you're going to sleep each night, or going to bed not knowing what you're going to do tomorrow. It's exciting. Despite the setbacks and the lonely nights, broken down in the remotest of places, furthest away from anyone to give me a helping hand, I wouldn't change it for the world. So get this right, apparently you're not supposed to drive on a salt lake. I did just that, and I ended up getting bogged out in this salt lake, like at least 15 Ks out of town, and my car was stuck. It was not getting out. There was no way for me to try and get myself out of this situation. There's no trees to use the winch to try and pull the car out, nothing like that. I went into town and I asked like 10 people with four-wheel drives, hey mate, can you give me a hand? I've got myself in a sticky situation out on the salt lake. And crickets, absolutely nothing. No one was willing to help me. I was in like the worst depressive mood. I was just like, oh my gosh, like why is society such a... I ended up spending 48 hours stuck out in this salt lake, and I was full on digging into the ground. Like I dug about 5 to 6 different holes into the ground to try and bury my spare wheel, to wrap my winch around the wheel, bury the wheel, and then try and winch off that as an anchor point. And each time it just pulled the tire out. To make matters worse, I didn't even have a shovel, like a proper shovel to dig the hole. So I'm just like clawing my hands in the ground, using my axe to try and split this really tough salt lake ground up. To no prevail, I wasn't able to get the car out. I moved the car about 100 meters over the course of 48 hours. But to be honest, I had enough food to get me by, and I was planning to stay out there for a few days anyway. I also had a bit of acne at the time, and I thought I might as well have a natural mud bath while I was out there. So I used the water that naturally rose from the ground into the holes that I was digging to make a bit of mud to then have a bit of fun on my face with the mud. Because what else are you going to do out there, right? But thankfully, I was able to put a post up on a bogged Facebook page where people put up posts for when they get into such sticky situations. And I was lucky enough to get a comment back from someone who lived 2 hours away, who drove down to help pull me out in their Nissan Navara. I am eternally grateful as they were able to pull me out, and I was free again. It's a strange feeling when you sit long enough in nature and you don't have a single thought. It's like you blend with it. You lose yourself. There's no one to call you by your name. Everything's just happening. However, you feel more connected to everything and everyone than ever before. The art of being alone and all together at the same time. I've been traveling far and wide to unknown places along lonely, empty roads. But this is a different journey, an inner journey, following the spirit of the traveler who doesn't travel. Physical or mental travel, if you will, the absolute experience of absolute freedom. And as a wise bloke once said, do not feel lonely, the entire universe is inside you. Stop acting so small, you are the universe in ecstatic motion, set your life on fire. Here's to the seekers, searchers and roamers, journeying inward to untouched lands that lay deep within. It's a search for something more, this yearning to understand what this world is really for, why it's here, or at least finding the answer to who I am. Am I nothing? Am I everything? It's a life's journey to try and comprehend, but it seems through a moment of stillness, a moment of silence, answers are found. This state of being of no thought, nothingness, emptiness, witnessing eternity in a brief instance. The darkness is peaceful, a place of purity, presence, no space for thoughts or desires. Nothing is lacking. The whole world belongs to you. In that minute, I try to grasp it and hold on to it, and it disappears. So I've been house sitting for about a week now, and I must say it's been nice house sitting and looking after the dogs, enjoying some company and just having a place to myself. Is kind of amazing sometimes. Kind of get sick of traveling at times, to be honest. A chance to relax and not be on the go all the time. Like traveling, you got to find somewhere to camp or somewhere to sleep for the night, and then you have to plan where you're going to adventure tomorrow. And it's just a constant cycle of go, 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 go. And I mean, there is moments of relaxation, but a lot of it seems to always be just going. It's like I get sick of traveling and want to settle down, and then I get sick of hanging around and want to travel again. I guess it's time to pick a place and travel on.